In this video, we're going to walk you through how to install a Link steerable lift axle. This instruction is intended solely for use with this product. Before beginning, complete the following. First, ensure the truck is on flat ground, then apply the parking brake. Make sure to chock the wheels and follow all proper safety and maintenance procedures. Assemble your tools and keep the instructions to refer to during this installation. Verify the truck is configured properly for the lift axle. Measure the frame width and check that it matches specifications. Review the intended suspension location and verify the axle will have proper clearance and load distribution in the lifted and lowered position. If there's any interference with existing frame bolts or brackets, it should be addressed prior to installation. Finally, verify the truck's air supply supports adequate braking with the lift axle installed and that the braking is compliant with FMVSS 121. To begin, measure and record the loaded frame height. Verify these measurements with OEM recommendations. To determine the appropriate frame mount kit, use the formula loaded frame height minus loaded tire radius equals ride height. Then refer to the provided lift chart in your installation instructions. When measuring frame to ground clearance, be sure to measure with the vehicle loaded at the intended suspension location. Link offers frame bracket kits to account for a wide range of ride heights and mounting requirements. Standard height mounting kits are designed primarily for use in configurations where additional equipment may need to be bolted to the truck frame above the mounting brackets. Tall mounting kits are designed for configurations where additional equipment is not bolted to the truck frame above the brackets. Before determining the suspension location, thoroughly review federal and local bridge laws. For purposes of increased weight carrying capacity or improved weight distribution, the minimum distance of 97 inches between axles as defined by the Federal Bridge Code may be increased but never decreased. For pusher configurations, the center of the axle must be 97 inches from the rear axle of the existing drive suspension. For tag configurations, the intended location must be 97 inches from the first drive axle to the existing suspension. In this demonstration, we are installing the lift axle in a pusher configuration. The front frame bracket of the lift axle must be 121 inches from the rear axle of the existing suspension. The truck's frame crossmember should also be at or near the intended front frame bracket of the lift axle. With the suspension location determined, clamp the front and rear frame brackets to the truck frame rails. Double-check the suspension location and verify the drilling will not interfere with any brake lines, fuel lines, air lines, wiring, or other components that might be located on the inside of the frame. Once the frame brackets are clamped securely to the outside and bottom surfaces of the truck frame, check the installation instructions for recommended mount hole locations. Then center punch all mount holes. With the holes marked, drill hole sizes according to the installation instructions at hole location. Attach the frame brackets to the frame with the intended fasteners. Tighten fasteners to specified installation instruction torque values. Secure the suspension to the front frame brackets using the provided mounting hardware. Center the suspension on the truck using the profile notches on the hanger as a visual indicator. Follow the proper sequence listed in your installation manual. Pre-torque and final torque all mounting hardware to ensure proper performance and durability of the suspension. Connect the load springs to the rear frame brackets using the intended fasteners. Tighten the fasteners to the specified installation instruction torque values. The steering stop screw is preset for maximum steer angle available without bottoming the steering shock absorber. For proper plumbing instructions, refer to the installation instructions that came with your chosen air control kit. For this demonstration, we are installing an integrated air control kit. Connect the pressure protection valve directly to the air supply tank on the truck using the provided fittings. Install the provided connector into the output port of the pressure protection valve. Mount the air controls in the desired locations for the driver's convenience, making sure the air controls are easily accessible. Most states require the controls to be mounted on the exterior of the truck, but some states may allow the air control switch to be mounted in cab. Connect the truck's air brake signal line using the provided T-fitting. Route all air lines to the bulkhead plate of your suspension using the plumbing schematics provided in your installation instructions. With the plumbing complete, disconnect the battery before working with the vehicle's electrical system. Make all wiring connections to the relay shown in the air control kit installation instructions. Make sure to crimp push-on connectors to wires and mount them in the supplied relay base. Make connections with the toggle switch to the terminal on the relay, as well as to the black wire from the solenoid valve wire harness. Attach the white wire from the solenoid valve wire harness to a reliable grounding point on the truck. Mount the toggle switch and toggle switch plate to the interior of the truck in a desired location. When all electrical connections have been made, reconnect the battery, pressurize the system, and tighten any fittings that are leaking. For final assembly, verify the following. All fasteners are installed and tightened to recommended torque specifications. Wheel hubs are sufficiently filled with manufactured specified lugricant. All wheel lug nuts are tightened to recommended torque specifications. Brakes and slack adjusters are properly set, and wheels are free to rotate. The tow in is set properly to installation specifications. The suspension has been inspected for clearance, and it raises and lowers without any interference between the lift axle and truck components. Air controls have been checked for leaks and proper operation. To verify proper operations, turn the key to the crank position to start the engine. Raise the lift axle by moving the toggle switch to the raised position. Lower the axle by moving the toggle switch to the lower position. Use the regulator to adjust the air pressure on the gauge to the appropriate air pressure for the vehicle load conditions. Refer to the chart in your owner's manual for recommended pressures. If the lift axle did not comply with proper operations, please refer to your installation instructions for troubleshooting tips. This completes the installation of a Link steerable lift axle. For more information, refer to the written manual by your vehicle manufacturer or contact Link Manufacturing.